Yo, what is going on, guys? Jack here, and welcome to my first Football Manager 2015 playthrough here with Arsenal in the Premier League. Hopefully you guys are good. I asked people on Twitter what team they wanted to see me take over. This is only going to be a short-term save during the beta. I have some plans on my horizon for when the full game is out and there's databases in place. But I've never done a save with a bigger team in England, so it's something that I'm looking forward to doing, is something a little bit different. And we're going to be kicking things off here with Arsenal. So I've already kind of set up the game as I wish to have it. As you guys know, with my kind of format in general, I'll go back at the end of certain periods, especially at the start of seasons, and look back on the pre-season period. That's exactly what we're going to be doing today. In terms of the board expectations, we'll see what they have to say. I'd love to learn more about the club. Tell me more. So wage and transfer budget are okay. I might see if we can push that up a little bit. I kind of feel quite confident. I've got to be honest. I feel like I should be able to win the league with Arsenal, with a few minor changes. But we'll see how we get on. So there we go. That's that meeting done. I'll tell my assistant that I'll get his help if I need it. So anyway, having a look at our season expectations. You can see them here. Our minimum expectation is we qualify for the Champions League for our Premier League position, which is for 47 million. I'm really tempted to take the title challenge one. I've got to be honest, I feel quite confident. I feel like I've got a good feeling about this save. Put it that way, I feel like a title challenge should be on the cards from season one. So, on that note, I'm going to take a risk and do that. The Arsenal squad as a whole isn't too bad. I don't really know what system I'm going to play just yet, but if we look at the kind of squad here, you can see if I just sort by position, we're pretty well rounded off as a squad. I don't feel like there's too much wrong with the team as a whole. Maybe lacking a few defenders. I know the centre-back position is a position that in real life gets under a lot of scrutiny for Arsenal. In Football Manager, I actually don't think it's too bad. I think Koscielny and Mertesacker should be okay, even if they are a little bit on the slow side. I don't really know what direction I'm going to take this team yet. I need to work out a formation and tactic system. I need to work out stuff. But, I mean, looking at the key players in our team, you can see here, Mesut Ozil is considered one of our best players. So, going to be probably looking to retain the services of him. There's a few players here who I feel as if they're probably getting a little bit on a little bit in terms of their age. And I might look to sell them. Players like Arteta, Rositsky, Kazula, Podolski. I feel like we've got some good young players coming through, you know, the likes of Oxlade-Chamberlain, obviously Welbeck, who's joined this year. So I don't feel like those players are necessarily required, so I might look to move them on, maybe free up some funds. But anyway, I'll join you guys at the end of pre-season. Hopefully I can work out a direction I want to take this side in. And yeah, hopefully things go to plan. So I'll talk to you guys in just a second. And we will be playing our first game today, which is in the Community Shield against Manchester City. So I'll talk to you guys in a second. Okay, guys, so we are back. A little over a month has passed. I've had a renovation and a half. I going into this, I didn't think I was going to make too many changes, to be honest. I felt like the Arsenal team was okay. But the more I looked at it, the more I ended up changing. And ultimately, I think I've come out pretty good from all of this. So anyway, what I'll do first is I'm going to show you the transfers. We'll start with them. So look at the transfer history. You can see £122 million spent. And I managed to recoup just under £84 million. So that was a pretty good kind of recoup, I guess, of some of the money. Looking at the big sales, we sold Cazorla to Liverpool for £22 million. Don't get me wrong, Cazorla's a great player, but he was never going to be a starter for me. And to get 20-odd million for a player of kind of his likeness, I think is pretty decent. His wages weren't cheap either. Similarly with Podolski, who was on, I think, 100 grand a week. He's an okay player, Podolski, but he is a bit of a leech on the finances. So to get rid of him for 15 million or just under was pretty decent. And the last big sale we made was Aaron Ramsey, who I've sold to Manchester United for £35 million. And on the face of it, that seems like a crazy bit of business in terms of why would you sell Aaron Ramsey? There's a few reasons behind this. First and foremost, the system I'm going to play means he isn't the perfect fit. If I compare him to Wiltshire, Wiltshire is a lot better, so I didn't want to sell Jack. and I needed to get a bit more money in. And to get £35 million for a player who's good, don't get me wrong, Aaron Ramsey's very good, but he's incredibly injury prone and isn't incredible, I think it's quite a good bit of business. I do think that Aaron Ramsey is underrated a tad in FM. So that kind of weighed into my decision a little bit. Other big kind of sales that are notable, Nacho Monreal went to Newcastle. You'll see on the left, I did bring in an alternative left back, so I didn't really need a third choice one behind the new left back in Gibbs. Sanogo's gone out on loan. Rennie Smith's gone out on loan. And then we did sell Arteta for $1.7 million. The reason for that was to do with his wages just being ludicrous. So anyway, moving on to the transfers on the ins, there's one here which I'm just going to address straight away because I know it's going to split the chat completely and split the comments. I've bought Raheem Sterling for £42.5 million. I had the money. I wanted to do it. He's a very good player in Football Manager. I like him a lot as a player in real world football, as a Liverpool fan. And I do actually have a very strong belief in him to come good for us. So we've got him, and he's going to be playing out on the right for us. I've got Royce. Yes, the Royce. I managed to grab him. He has a release clause in FM of £21 million at Dortmund. So that is something that if you've got £21 million lying around, as you do, you might want to consider getting him in. He's a fantastic player, the German international. They're going to be playing on the left for us, cutting in on his right foot. So that was a great bit of business. The other two first-team signings I made was Marcelo, who we've got in to play at the left wing-back position. Just an incredible player. I'm really happy to get him in for £20 million as well. As you can see by his value, he's valued at over £20 million already. Amazing technicals. One of the best left-backs in the world football in real life. One of the best left-backs in FM. He's only 26. He's got plenty of years left in him. And the other signing we made was another Real Madrid player. It was Sami Khedira, who I've got. And he's another one of the best defensive midfielders. It's something that I firmly believe Arsenal have lacked for a very long time. It's just a kind of man of steel in the centre. You know, the Vieiras have gone. There hasn't been a day of a Vieira. I'm hoping that Sami Khedira is going to fill a void that I think Arsenal have been having for quite some time. He's a fantastic player, amazing mentals, a great centre mid. He's going to be a more defensively minded player, and to get him in for £18 million was another really good bit of business. The only three other transfers I made were all young prospects. Bonazzoli I already covered in my Wonder Kids Attackers video. If you've missed that, you can go on my YouTube channel and you'll find it. It's on the homepage in one of the playlists. Great Wonder Kid, you can get him for £1 million, so I decided to pick up him. I picked up Edda Alvarez Balanta. I don't really need to explain too much about this guy. He's a really good centre-back. Obviously, I mentioned the fact that I do have Kashani and Mertesacker, and I was kind of weighing up replacing them. But I kind of mentioned before I started that I kind of feel like they're okay in FM. Balanta's going to kind of maybe work his way into the team. I feel like he'll complement either of those centre-backs quite nicely because of his great pace. He's a very good player in Europe and in other competitions. He's going to play a fair bit of football. The last player I brought in was for £12.25 million, and it was Youri Tielemans, or however you want to say it, answers on a postcard. But this is a very, very good young player, one of the best young players in Football Manager this year. Picked him up from Anderlecht for £12.25 million. As you can see, last year, at the age of 16, he made 29 appearances for Anderlecht. He's a fantastic player. Fairly good price paid, I think. He may go out on loan this year, but I would like to get him first-team football, be it with me or be it afar. So anyway, those are the transfers, and you're probably wondering, with the additions of Sterling and Royce, well, where is this tactic going? How are you actually going to play? Because you've got Ozil, you've got Sanchez, you've got obviously Giroud, Welbeck. There's a lot of players there who can play the same positions as these other players. So the tactic I'm going with is this. Now, unfortunately for this opening game in the Community Shield, we are going to be without Royce and Sterling. They're both recovering from medium-term injuries, which is a little bit of a shame. As you can see, Royce is going to be returning to full fitness in 30 days. So he's going to miss the start of the season, but Sterling's only out for another day. But this is the system I'm going to be playing. It's going to be a 4-2-3-1. Giroud is going to be the big man in the centre, who's hopefully going to be getting his head on the and he crosses into the box. In behind him, I'm going to have Sanchez, and I'm still not sure what role I'm going to play him as. I'm kind of weighing up Shadow Striker right now, but that may change. We're going to kind of go with the flow on that one, because Sanchez is a very good player. But in terms of as an actual player, Shadow Striker is probably his best role. My assistant agrees with that. He's a very good player, Sanchez. And I think he'll play very nicely as kind of a second striker off a big man, which is what we're going to be doing here. As I mentioned, we have Sterling and Royce. They are playing as inside forwards who are set to play narrower. And also, I think there's another instruction involved here, so I want to check it. No, it is just the sit narrower command. So we've got that. In behind, we've gone with a deep line playmaker support with dribble less and pass it shorter. That pass it shorter can go. But yeah, Ozil is going to be dropped into a deeper position, a position that he can't actually naturally play just yet. He's competent in it, but it's a position I want him to learn to play. I love Ozil as a player. I think he's a very good player, but I want to deploy him in a slightly deeper position just to kind of fit our system a little bit more. I want to have the athletic wingers slightly ahead of him, you know, the likes of Roy Sterling and Sanchez really providing energy. And I want him to kind of take a back seat in terms of not finding himself quite so high up the field. Alongside him, we have his German comrade, and that is Kadira, who we obviously signed. He is going to be occupying a ball in midfielder role with a pass it shorter on. In behind, we go with wing backs and centre backs. Nothing too fancy here, but we're playing with Debuchy on the right, Marcelo on the left, and then the centre. We are going to stick with Koscielny and Mertesacker to begin with. So that's the player roles themselves. Giroud's an advanced forward. In terms of everything else, you can see here, hit early crosses, exploit flanks, play wider, higher tempo. I want us to really focus on using the creative outlets we have out wide. Debuchy and Marcelo are both pretty useful going forward, so I'm going to be looking to get them into play where possible. Obviously, Royce, Sterling and Sanchez are just three incredible attacking midfielders. I'd argue that them as an attacking trio could be, if it was real, you know, up there, not quite alongside Neymar, Messi and Suarez, but they're kind of a slightly budget option of that kind of trio. So I'm very happy to have them there. In terms of for this game, I'm probably going to let my assistant deal with this and just pick a team and rejig stuff. I kind of have in my mind how I'm going to set up the team when everyone's fit. Obviously, Jack Wilshere isn't going to start in my current system. However, as you can see here, obviously, Ozil can push forward when we have got injuries. We've all, obviously, Sanchez can go out wide. We're very flexible in the final third in terms of the setup I can have with the three attacking midfielders that I intend to start with because they can occupy multiple positions, which is very, very useful. In terms of the mentality, I think I'm going to go on attacking to begin with a view to maybe mix that up depending on who we're playing on kind of a game-by-game basis. But other than that, I'm pretty happy with my assistant's kind of choice of players here. I'm very happy with my signings. I'll be interested to know what you guys make of the signings I made. Some fairly big names there, I think, that I was able to bring in. It wasn't easy, and obviously I know that selling a few of the players I sold isn't necessarily going to prove the most popular decision with you guys, the viewers. But I think to get £83 million for Cazorla, Podolski, Ramsey, Nacho Monreal and Arteta combined is a pretty decent bit of business. And I feel like what we've invested in is going to definitely be worth a lot more to us. So yeah, let's get into today's game. Marcelo is not going to play because his conditioning isn't great. Obviously, this is only the Community Shield, but it should be an interesting opportunity to see how we shape up against one of the better teams, I guess, in England. And obviously, I have told the board that I'm going for a title challenge. So there is a little bit of pressure on me to go out and get results. So this should give me a good idea in my mind of exactly how well our tactical system is going to work. Because I am kind of trying a system that I've never used before. And I guess with that comes an element of uncertainty. I'm going to be learning as I go. I have no doubt that the tactics that I'm using now are not going to be the tactics I'm using in 2 months. I'm sure there will be minor changes that I make and tweaks that happen based on the results and kind of what I observe. But right now I'm going to put faith in the players we have to see how they get on. So Belanta's going to get a start here. Koscielny's going to start alongside him. Mertesacker on the bench. Let's sort out our game speed. Unfortunately, there are not going to be kind of 3D highlights, guys. The reason for that being is I'm currently recording on a laptop. As some of you know, I'm in London at the moment working. As a result, I don't have my PC. So hopefully you guys don't mind that. We are going to be watching some amazing dots on screen. Match stats down the left. You guys know the setup by now. But hopefully we can get a result here. Gibbs down the left. Ball into the box. Company deals with it. Chambers. Kadira. Wiltshire. Giroud. Welbeck hits the crossbar on his debut. Wow, that could have been an incredible start. Unfortunately, it's just not gone our way. So in terms of this system, I'm hoping it's going to work quite well, this 4-2-3-1. I feel like the attacking trio of midfielders we have when fit is going to be pretty darn incredible. I'd be interested to know of the signings I've made, which you think is the best in terms of maybe as of a bit of business or just the best player. It's going to be tricky. Obviously, I'm sticking with Giroud up front. I was looking for a striker for quite some time who I felt would be an adequate kind of player for us. And I've got to be honest, Giroud is very, very good in FM. But there was a time when I was weighing up playing a 4-4-2 system. That's kind of not worked out just because I couldn't find an adequate striker and decided to invest in Sterling instead and kind of, I guess, switch to the free in midfield or free attacking midfield tactics. Giroud blasting it over, that's unlucky. But I mean, looking at the stats right now, we're doing okay. Loads of shots, not too many on target, not having a lot of the ball, but when we are having it, we look fairly lethal. So you can see the inside forwards sitting narrower. They are going to have to drop wide when we don't have the ball. But I've done a little bit of tactical tinkering over the preseason. I decided not to cover the preseason results as Nasri hits the crossbar from 40 yards. I decided not to cover the preseason results just because I was fiddling around my tactics a lot. And ultimately, it was more about getting match fitness. But we did play the likes of Anderlecht, who we beat 3-0, and a few other European teams. So that was quite a nice indication of kind of how we were getting on. But anyway, that's going to be half time. It's not the best first half, so I'm just going to tell the players I'm not happy at the moment. I want you to get a little bit fired up and try and do something different. Interesting to see Manchester City deciding to persevere with Aguero, who's currently injured. Kind of somewhat cynically dark inside of me, I'm kind of hoping that he continues to play and it injures him for a substantial period at the start of the season and maybe affects Manchester City's performances in the league. I do feel like the whole title challenge thing is going to be tricky this year in terms of maintaining it. I actually feel like kind of in the final third, we're going to be fine. I feel like goals is not going to be the issue that we're going to have unless Giroud goes particularly off. But even then, we have got the likes of Sanchez and Welbeck who are capable of kind of leading the line. My big concern comes at the back. And obviously, I've got Belhanda, who I'm kind of going to try and weed into the first team this year alongside Mertesacker and Koscielny, have that rotation where need be. But it is a concern kind of that in Christmas and in the Christmas period, you know, through January, I might have to evaluate my options there. There were players who I did look in to get. I did look at Nkulu at one point, but unfortunately he got snapped up. And so I decided to go with Belhanda as kind of a second choice because I knew he would develop and he'd be more of a long-term option, even if a short-term fix is probably more what's needed. But anyway, Manchester City taking a lead there. That's unfortunate, but as I mentioned, I'm not massively... I am bothered, but I'm not going to get kind of too fussy about us not playing particularly well in the Community Shield. This is a bit of a learning exercise, of course. A number of the new signings, such as Royce and Sterling, who are key first-team players, aren't playing today. So we are a little bit light in terms of, how we're set up. I'm a little bit concerned about the gaps between our defence and midfield, which you saw that attack build from. That's one of my big gripes, kind of with the 4-2-3-1 formation that I'm currently using and just the formation in general, is it can sometimes leave your centre-backs a tad kind of exposed. And given, as I mentioned, kind of, I guess, some of the issues, shall we say, that plague Arsenal's defence in real life that kind of have a knock-on effect of sorts in FM, that might be something I have to look to rectify, as Aguero has a shot, was offside. I'm going to make some changes here. I am going to bring on Tielemans, the youngster. I'm going to give him some minutes for Wiltshire. I'm treating this more as a pre-season friendly, if I'm honest, but it would have been great to win a bit of silverware. But now I'm kind of resigned to the fact it's probably not going to go our way. I'm going to bring on Sterling, even though he's only got 77% condition. I want to give him a little bit of a run out. So for the last 14 minutes here, it should give him a chance to just kind of run his legs and get a little bit of match fitness. And I'm also going to bring on Tabucci. But anyway, I don't know when the next episode is going to be in this. I think I'm going to do it maybe every month. I'd be interested to know down in the comments how often you think these like kind of updates should be. I don't want to make them too frequent because I plan on doing the save maybe for the weeks of the beta and then maybe a week or two afterwards. But it's certainly not a save that I want to drag on too much. And as a result, I'd like to get a little boy into the future as well. Beck scores their header. Let's go. Maybe we're going to have, I was about to say added time, but I have an odd sneaking suspicion that it might go straight to penalties, the Community Shield. I might be wrong. If we could get another, that'd be amazing. Raheem with another cross. Tielemans. The subs are linking up Debucci. All the subs are involved. Welbeck back post. Heads it across. Sanchez. He's got to bury it. Sterling can't bury it. Oh, it should have been a goal. It should have been. But Joe Hart holds firm. I'll tell you what, this game has burst into life in the last 10 minutes. Apparently my subs have worked wonders. Although they've now got a chance here. Silver with the effort saved. I'll tell you what, Chesney has had a fantastic game. There was a period in pre-season where I was weighing up selling Mesut Ozil. And I still might do. As much as Arsenal fans are going to not like that, I had an option to sell him for about 50 million to Chelsea. In the end, I decided to pull out of that. But it might be something I look to maybe reaffirm, especially because, as I've already mentioned, we kind of have a lot of strength in the midfield area right now. And of course, Wiltshire has actually been forced out because Ozil's deployed in that deeper position. I'd be interested to know how much you reckon Ozil is worth in FM if you've been playing as Sanchez misses a penalty. Well, that's a good start. That is not the start I wanted for Sanchez. He's missed it. Well, hopefully Aguero can screw up here. Chesney in the game was fantastic for us. As you can see, there were three clear-cut chances either way and a real distinct lack of clinicalness. I'm going to turn up our match highlights here because I don't want this penalty shootout to drag on for too long. And right now it's taking a while. But Aguero does score to make it 1-0 to Manchester City. If you're wondering about the lack of logo packs and stuff, right now I'm focusing more on getting the videos out. One of the issues I have with the logo packs and stuff is that as a Football Manager fan site, all the Football Manager official kind of social media platforms, they're not allowed to share videos with unlicensed graphics and names and all that jazz in. So as a result, I'm just playing things safe so that maybe we can get a few of the videos that I do shared around. But anyway, this is not going to plan right now at all. Manchester City 2-1 up in the penalty shootout. Debuchy to step up and he will hammer it in. That's another goal. Dzeko now. Come on, Chesney. Please work your magic. Please do it for me. I've got faith in you. I've got faith. Dzeko. Oh, well, what a save. Assuming it was a save and it didn't hit the crossbar, it can be a little bit tricky to tell. I feel like asking my assistant to choose the penalty takers was a mistake, because right now my centre-back's about to take a penalty and Debuchy took the last one. But either way, Belanta, he's shutting me up right there. He is defeating all the stereotypes of centre-backs not being able to take free kicks. Can Vincent Kompany do the same here for Manchester City? He steps up. He hits it down the middle. That's a goal. He sends the keeper the wrong way. And now we're into essentially a sudden death situation with it tied 3-3 on penalties. Come on, Danny Welbs. Come on, Welbs. Bury it. Do it for me. For the fans, he's missed it. I never liked Danny Welbeck. He only has 10 composure in FM. And it's shown right there. He's lost it. And now James Milner, who's like the most reliable player in the world, has a chance to win the game and win silverware for Man City. And he will do it. So that is an unfortunate result in the end to lose in that manner. However, I'm pretty pleased with how our team performed, considering that wasn't my strongest team. Manchester City squad was fairly strong. They had the likes of Nasri, David Silva, Yaya Toure, Aguero all playing for them. So that it could have been worse. I'm kind of trying to look on the brighter side of things there. The fact that a tactic that's not tested against a big, stiff opposition was able to go toe-to-toe gives me some optimism. So yeah, hopefully you enjoyed this first episode. I think the next episode is going to either be the Champions League best playoff stage, although we're playing quite a small team, so I'm probably not even going to do that. I think I'll be back for the Manchester United game, which is on the 13th of September. So that's in a month's time. That will give me time to finish off the transfer window and all that jazz. Guys, if you enjoyed the video, as always, if you could smash the like button, if we can get to 300 likes... I'll try and get an episode up for you guys tomorrow, and that will be the Manchester United episode. I'd be interested to know what you made of my signings, as I mentioned, down in the comments. What do you think of paying $42 million for Raheem Sterling? I feel like it's a bit of a risk, but I'm pretty hopeful and pretty certain in my gut that it's going to go our way. So yeah, guys, as I mentioned, thank you for watching. If you're new around here, hit the subscribe button. And other than that, I will talk to you guys in a bit. It's me, Jack, and I'm out.